מסכת חולין, page 19. We'll start today on page 18b, 11 lines from the bottom of the page. As we learned in the past several days, when it's come to שחיטה, שבאים לשחוט, when it's about to do the mitzvah of kosher שחיטה, you have to do it בצוואר, you have to do it in the neck. And the question is, מאיפה עד איפה, from where to where, we have to do this mitzvah. So the central piece of our study today, it's Mekom HaShechita, the proper place to do the Shechita. And as we learned in the past, there are two important components when it's come to Shechita. One, it's called Kaneh. Kaneh is a white pipe. And
windpipe.
Windpipe, thank you. Windpipe, thank you. And the other one is Veshet. Esophagus. Thank you. So when it's come to the kaneh, the wine pipe, the windpipe, so that's in Hebrew, it's called tzinor haneshima, the pipe that gives the animal the capability to breathe. The veshet, the esophagus, it's the pipe, is a tzinor that is a very soft, is rach, and darko nichnas ha'ochel, toward that pipe, the animal can eat. Now, the veshet, the esophagus, is soft, is rach, and therefore the din, the halacha is nikav, nekev echad, even they have one little hole, then behema, the animal cannot be fitting for kosher slaughter. Versus when it's come to a windpipe, to a kaneh, that's a different story. Kaneh is a tzinor neshima, is the pipe, windpipe that bring the breath of life, the air. So the psilut, the condition to make that part of the shechita, that part of the animal, the windpipe, pasul, only nifsak rubo, we learn, only in the majority of that pipe was detached. So in general, the orech, that pipe, murkav mitabaot, it contain ring, as we learned in the previous dapim, and those tabaot, those rings, makifot, until the schus, until, meaning it's not total close, and there is a, they're not total locked. Lo legamre nin alot. It's not total locked, but what happened is they have a small piece of meat, chatichat basar, shemechaberet, that make it an attachment, excluding one place, which we call it yesterday, the tabat ha'elyona. In the Lashon Chachamim, the language of our sages, is called the tabat gdola, that ishleima, it's in full, makifa, it kol, Koter HaKaneh, it's combined the entire windpipe. And that's the way Rashi explained that what Rav and Shmuel hold, that we can do the Shechita only in a Tabat HaGdola. Even you see what we learned yesterday, the Rashi said that in some cases can do it between the Tabaot, but when it's come to the Me'al HaTabat, they have which we call the Kova, there's a few ways to explain it, but the kova is when you look at the animal's neck, you see the grogeret boletet. So they have this, the slant of the hamlet, and its peak, its term, it's called chuda de chova, the point of the hamlet. That's the way Rashi said. So the hamlet refers to the thyroid cartilage. Helmet, cartilage, the thyroid cartilage, right? So that's the shipuya kova. I think the best is to describe like a flute, like you have in those instruments that they have shinui bakova, right? But what we're going to study in short today is we focus on the windpipe, on the kaneh, which is kol orech hakaneh, the entire windpipe, from the head, meharosh adareot, from the head to the lung. So that's basically we need to know how far you can go with the shechita. There are certain opinions in a certain section, where is exactly in the windpipe, how far you go, and when you can have the hagrama, which we learned yesterday, the hataya, to another, meaning you start and then you switch to a different direction, when exactly it makes it psilut. So again, we start on 18b, 11 lines from the bottom of the page. Rabbi Shimon ben Lakish, achshar bechuda dechova. Rabbi Shimon ben Lakish hold that when it's come to a kosher shechita, kosher butchering, so they have to be, the helmet has to be valid, which means that the sharp part. Kare alei Rabbi Yochanan. Rabbi Yochanan call upon this statement of Reish Lakish, Kish, Gisa Gisa. So Rashi said here, Hages Hages Klomar, and as you know, always search what Rashi meant when he used the word Klomar. So Rashi said, Hages Hages, meaning too much, too much. And Rashi said, כלומר יותר מדי הכשרת, דאין כאשר אפילו רבי חנינא למקום שחידודו מתחיל לעלות. So, even רבי חנינא, when he hold that you can do it, so the שחיטה is valid only up to the point where the helmet begins to slant. אמר רב פאפי משמי דרבה, Paga bechitei, if the slaughterer met the wheat kernels. So Rashi said here, glance dumyan lechitin, umonachim ala kane etzel akova. So that's the metari kolba behema, the part of the animal that it's like the vocal part. But he said it's a trifa. So basically the same as we said, is as we explained yesterday, if he shachat batabat and ba'emtza in the middle, a sakin barcha, the knife ran away outside. So that's we learned the machloket. Here of Papi Mishmei Rava said, if he hits while he's doing the shechita, he met the wheat kernel, so the animal is not kosher, it's treifa. So what exactly means by saying paga? So ibayelu, what does that mean? Paga venagabe, dechtiva evgabo vayamot, which means that he has touched them. That's the pasuk that is instructing him and he died. Or odilma, Paga velo naga, dichti vayivgiu vo malachei Elokim. They said that he met but not touched them. They said about Yaakov Avinu, that they approach him. So the Gemara did not give the answer for that question. Itmar amar Rav Papa Mishmei Derava, shir bechitei, if he left over some of the wheat kernel, which means he severed the corniculate cartilage. So ksheira, the animal, is kosher. So the later the Gemara on 19 explained because he slaughtered mishipu yakova ulemata. So that's the reason why it's okay. It's ksheira. Amar Rav Amei Marbar Mar Yenuka. הווה קאימנה קמי דרבי חייא ברי דרב אביה ואמרי לי שייר בחיטי כשאירה. So he said, left over some of the wheat kernel, the animal is kosher. אמר לי רבינה לרבה שאמר לי רב שימן מסוברה, it's the name of a place, איקלה מרזוטרה לאטרין ודרש שייר בחיטי כשאירה. Fine. Not everyone agreed, there is a point that disputed Rav Papa. מר ברר דר, מר בר רב אשי אמר, פגע בחיטי כשירה, yes, however, שייר בחיטי טריפה, but he left over some of the wheat kernel, then it's not kosher. So, פגע, meaning it's come close, but he didn't touch it. So Marba Rav Ashi hold that here when we talk about Chitei, it's not a place that is not befitting for Shechita, but you can do Shechita under them because it's above the Tabat HaElyonah, above the highest ring, which means his view follow the first view of Rav Papi. So where exactly is the right place for Shechita? You see here a four different locations. One is the view of Reish Lakish. So Reish Lakish holds that Chudo Shel Kova. So it's valid up to the point of the helmet, which is the peak of the thyroid cartilage. Two is the view of Rabbi Yochanan. He said only Mishipuya Kova Vamata. He said, if you go by Rashi, is the upper limit for Shechita is the slant of the helmet, which is the point at which the thyroid cartilage begins to taper. Right? Rav Papa, Rav Chia, and Marzutra hold that Shechita through the corniculate cartilage is valid. That's basically the same as Rabbi Yochanan. Then we have Rav Papi, the first explanation in the Gemara. They said here, in Marzutra Baravashi, that Shechita is valid only up to the bottom surface of the corniculate cartilage. And Rav Papi, according to the second explanation in the Gemara, Tachat Chitei, which is that Shechita is not valid even in the area immediately beneath the corniculate cartilage. Page 19, Vehilcheta, and the Halacha, the law of Shechita is Mishipui Kova Ulmata Ksheira V'hainu deshayer bechitei. So the law of the Shechita is, Rashi tells us, Kodem sheyatchil hakova leshafeya, which means from the slant of the helmet and below is valid. And this is the same as we said that where he left over some of the wheat kernel, so the Shechita is valid. The source for that. Rav Nachman achshar mishipui kova lemata. Omar le-Rav Hanan barav ktina le-Rav Nachman keman, according to whom you are ruling, lo kerabanan, not according to the Tana Kama in the Mishnah, ve-lo kerab Yossi bar Yehuda, because both of them said that you can do it only where tabayet ha-gdola and not above it. Amar le-Rav Nachman said, ana lo chilak yadana ve-lo bilak yadana, which means the halachan is neither according to Tana Kama, not according to Rabbi Yossi Bar Yehuda. It's a chilak and bilak is the Aramaic expression that said this is like ploni and almoni. So they said, ana shmata yadana, de omar Rabbi Chia bar Abba amar Rabbi Yochanan, v'amr la amar Rabbi Abba bar Zavda amar Rabbi Yochanina, v'amr la amar Rabbi Yaakov bar Idi amar Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi, mishipui kova velemata deshchita, from the slant of the helmet and below is valid. Source, Omar Rabbi Yeshua ben Levi, Mugremet de Rabbanan. He said that a cut that is beyond the limit by the sages, which means if partially went above the great ring, Kshera le Rabbi Yose bar Rabbi Yehuda, with Rabbi Yossi bar Yehuda, cut that is deemed beyond the limits by Rabbi Yossi bar Yehuda, the most of the cut went above the great ring, Kshera le Rabbi Chanina ben Antigonus. It's valid according to Rabbi Chanina ben Antigonus. So as long as he is Mishipui Akova velemata. So the Gemara said Pshita, obvious. Ma'u de teima Rabbi Chanina ben Antigonus arad de Rabbanan kai. Kamash Melan. You may say Rabbi Chanina ben Antigonus is refer only to the statement of the sages, which means that disagree only with the sages and agree with Rabbi Yossi, which means that if he made the entire Shechita above the greatest ring. So he, if in, he agreed that it's Hagrama and make it possible, Kamash Melan. So therefore, Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi come to teach us that Rabbi Hanina ben Antignos allowed even in this situation, which means that Rabbi Hanina ben disagree even with Rabbi Yossi. So it's that so Rabbi Hanina does agree with Rabbi Yossi. So they said im kene idale ami bayale. So the text in the Braita should be Rabbi Hanina ben Antignos testified about it. So vehilcheta Rabbi Hanina ben Antignos dekai Rav Nachman kvates. You know in the Shas many times Rav Nachman was the one of the most chashuvis, Av Beis Din, etc., etc. So there is a Marsha here and Rashash and Shut Radvaz and Romei Sadeh and more, Plati, the dealing with what is the language of the Eid. But anyway, Amar Rav Una, Amar Rav Asi, Machloket B'Sheshachat Shnei Shlish Ve'Egrim Shlish. Says that the disputation, if he slaughtered two-thirds of the part, right? The windpipe. Within the great ring, the green shlish, which means that it then cut the remaining third beyond the limit, which is above the great ring. So what's the machloket? The Rabbanan Savrei. So the sages hold Kula Shchita Beinan Betabal Gdola. The entire Shchita require within the great ring, including the last part. Rabbi Yossi Barab Yudah Savar Rubo Kechulo. Rabbi Yossi Barab Yudah hold that cut within the great ring through most of the windpipe is tantamount to cut within the great ring through the entire windpipe. Aval igrim shlish v'shachat shnei shlish. But if the first he just cut one third beyond the limits and then cut the remaining two third within the limits, divrei kol psula, everyone said that the shechita is invalid. When the life of the animal departs, beinan ruba bishchita. We need the majority, and must have been made in a manner valid for shechita, veleika, and we don't have that. Rav Chisda challenged Rav Huna, and he suggests another explanation. So this disputation between Tanakama and Rabbi Yosef and Rabbi Yudah. Omar le Rav Chisda. Rav Chisda said to Rav Huna, Adirabba, the other way around. Leima mar ipcha. You should say the other way around. So the it's based on the Gemara Bava Metzia 33, because he was Rebbe, he asked in a very respectful way. He should say, the master should say the other way around. מחלוקת כשהגרים שליש ושחת שני שליש ורבי יוסי ברבי יהודה סבר מידי אהבה חצי קנה פגום. So just the other way around, and רבי יוסי ברבי יהודה said that since it is similar to the one in which half of the windpipe was damaged, so you have a pre-existing situation that the half of the windpipe and the slaughter, they extended slightly so that most of the windpipe is severed. So therefore the Shechita is valid. And the sages, the Rabbanan, which is Tanakama, that disputed Rabbi Yossi, and makes the Shechita invalid, hold that is not uncomparable, the two scenario. Hatam mekom Shechita. Over there, in the case of damaged windpipe, the initial part is an area designated for Shechita. Hacha, when it's a grim and a third, one third, Shlish Rishon, Lav mekom shechita. It's not prescribed area for shechita. Why? Because the center of chayuta behemah, the center of life of the animal, needs to come out by chatach rova siman, chetach rova siman, that the most of the sign, they have to be the first ruba, and not only the point that complete the cut. So if he did the hagrama of the one-third tchila, so miktzat chayut lo bimkom shechita. So therefore the shechita is not valid. Amar le Rav Yosef. No, I'm sorry. So they said, Aval Rav Chisda completed and said, Aval shachat shnei shlish ve'egrim shlish. Aval shachat shnei shlish ve'egrim shlish. But if he first cut two-thirds within the limits, and then cut the remaining third beyond the limits, divrei akol ksheira, even according to Tanakama, it's valid. The Hatnan, because we learn in the Mishnah 27, rubo shel echad kamo, cutting the greater part of one pipe is like cutting all of it. Omar Rav Yosef, Rav Yosef said to Rav Chisda, Manane malan da'u ruba de'atam. Who can say to us that the law about the greatest part mentioned here is that Mishnah, Lav Rav Yosef, Rav Yehuda katan ela. Dilma Rav Yosef, Rav Yehuda katan ela. Omar le'abaye, Atu kol rubei de'alma. Rabbi Yosef bar Rabbi Yehuda ketan elu. Say that all the principles, all the halachot that base on the principle that rubo kechulo, that you have it in many places, so you say that it's only follow the view of Rabbi Yosef bar Rabbi Yehuda, and the sages disputed him. Omar lei ana ruba de shechita kaimna de shamana lehu de fligei. Rashi here used the word klomar, Haruba de Mapik Chayuta Bey Bainan Bishchita, is a book called Torat Chaim that expands on that. But anyway, so Lishna Achrina, Omar Le Ayosan Haruba de Shchita Kemen, Shemen Le Flugi, Lishna Achrina Amri La Amaravuna Amaravasi, Machloket Kshigrim Shlish, Veshachat Shnei Shlish, the Rabbi Yossi Barab Yuda Savar Mide de Ava Chatzika Nepagum, Verabanan Hata Mekom Shchita, Hachalav Mekom Shchita. אבל, זה סיים מהלך, אבל שחת שני שליש והגרים שליש, דברי הכל כשירה, דעתנן, רובו של אחד כמוהו. So, מתקיף לרב חיסדה. מן לי מלאך דהו רובה דהתם, לב רבי יוסי ברבי יהודה קטן אלה. He said, רב חיסדה challenged and he said, who can say to us that the law about the greater part we have here in that Mishnah, it was not taught by Rabbi Yosef Bar Yehuda. Maybe Rabbi Yosef Bar Yehuda is the one who teaches Rubo Shel Echad Kamo. Omar Rabbi Yosef, Atu kol de Rube de Alma, Rabbi Yosef Bar Yehuda Ketan Elo. Amar Le Ana Ruba de Shechita Kaamina, de Shaman Elo de Flige. And I've heard that the sages and Rabbi Yosef disagree about this very point. So Gemara said, Igrim shlish, shachat shlish, v'igrim shlish, Ravuna amarav, kshira, Rav Yehuda amarav, treifa. Ravuna amarav, kshira, kinafka chayuta, b'shchita kanafka. Says, when the animal's life departs, it departs to the shchita. Rav Yehuda amarav, treifa, be'inan ruba, b'shchita, v'leika. They said here, the opposite way, Shachat Shlish, Ve'egrim Shlish, Ve'shachat Shlish. Rav Yehuda Amar Rav Kshera, Atu Shailua Leravuna, Amar Lehu Treifa. Why? Because that cut take away the life of the animal, which means the third, the middle third, that complete to the most of the windpipe, cut in the place that not befitting for Shechita. Shamar Rav Yehuda. So Rav Yehuda heard what Ravuna's rule, and he was unhappy. Ikpad, וזה נוי, אמר טריפנה ומחשר ומחשרנה טריף. What I said is not kosher, he said it is. And the other way around as well. אמר רבונה שפיר כמקפד. So Rav Yehuda's rule about himself, he said he's right to be annoyed. Chada, first, Iu shmi alei minei de Rav. That he learned from Rav that that shchita is kosher. Vana lo shmi alei. I just hold it by myself. So Rav's ruling is better than mine. Show anava, show humbleness. Ve'od is another reason to justify what Rav Yehuda said. Why? The situation that שחט שליש וגרים שליש then שחט שליש העיקר רופה בשחיטה. So they have the most of day windpipe is severed to the שחיטה. Even the middle part, the middle third, it's take to the הגרמה. אמר לרב חיסדא, רב חיסדא said to רבונה, לא תהה דרבך, you should not retract your original ruling that said that the shechita is invalid. Page 19b, the im ken, if you retract your words and you agree that if he is grim in the second shlish, in the middle, the second third inside, so it's befitting is kshera mafsad lach lekamaita. So you'll have retract your ruling in the first case, which is that the first third was outside the limits, the second third inside, and the final third outside. So the shechita is valid. Ha tamai tama kama chashrat. Why you rule, follow Rav, that the shechita is befitting? The chignafka chayuta, when the animal's life departs, behechsheira kanafka. It happens in the kosher, in the valid cut. So we have the fact that the moment the animal's life depart, it was the shlish emtzai shel hakaneh, which is the middle part, the second part inside the windpipe. Hachaname, here too, which is the same idea, which is if he slaughtered the third part, the first and the last one, which means the first third was outside the limits and the final third outside. So he said, "Hachaname kinafka chayuta behagrama kanafka." So it happens, but it's cut beyond the prescribed limit. So therefore, the shechita is not valid. Even most of the siman was cut in the proper way. There is a Rashi here that expands of all the halachot, and you see it more in the Yoredea, in Shulchan Aruch Yoredea Kavdalet, Nosa Kelim. Igla Rav Nachman Lesua, Bao Minei Shachat Shlish Veigrim Shlish Vachat Shlish Mao. That's exactly what we said before. When I did cut third of the a windpipe inside the designated area, and then he cut the third beyond the area, and then he cut the final third within the area. Amar lehu lav haynu de Rabbi Elazar ben Manyumi, de Amar Rabbi Elazar ben Manyumi, shechita ha'asuya chemasrek, shechita that make like a cut in a jag, like a comb, said is kshira, it's valid. My brother-in-law, הגאון רבי דוד אברהם מנדלבום שליטה, in his book Daf al Daf, he expanded a lot on this sugiya, and he brought the Beit Yosef, on Yoredei Akaf Aleph, he brought from Ma'ari ben Chaviv, and he said, I'm just quoting him, he said, כשיני המסרק שאינו חותך חיתוך ישר, רק חותך ומעקם וחוזר כנגדו המקום שהתחיל וחוזר ומעקם, וזה כמו המסרק, that it's not a straight way, וגם כן אלכסון כמו הקולמוס ואין חילוק ביניהם, רק שבאלכסון ראש השחיטה במקום אחד כמו קולמוס, אבל המסרק מעקם וחוזר כנגדו המקום שהתחיל. Anyway, he expanded on that, that בית יוסף. ודילמה במקום שחיטה, so they said, במקום שחיטה מי למאמרה, מהו דתמה בינן שחיטה מפורט, veleika. So you may think that here they need a clear cut, and there's no such a cut here. So therefore, Rabbi Elazar ben Manyumi informs us that we do not need such a cut. Siman bekaf dalet. That's a mnemonic bekaf dalet. Yativ Rabbi Abba achorei de Rav Kahana, v'yativ Rav Kahana tkamei de Rabbi Yuda. So again, my brother-in-law brought in Dafel Daf the Aderet. And the Aderet, in a book called Megillat Simanim Challenge here, said in one hand, Rabbi Abba achorei de Rav Kahana, and then he said, yativ Rav Kahana tkamei de Rav Yuda, v'yativ kamar, so you have a big mahalach over that. How exactly it happened, what exactly, or how it makes sense. It's above the scope of today. Welcome to read. Shachat shlish v'igrim shlish v'shachat shlish mau. Amar l'shchidato kshera igrim shlish v'shachat shlish v'igrim shlish. Amar l'shchidato psula. Shachat b'mkom anekev if he cut through the hole in the windpipe. Mau, what's the halacha? Amar l'shchidato kshera. Shachat u'paga bo nekev. If he cut and reach a hole in the windpipe, mahu, what's the halacha? Amar lei, he said, shchitato psula. Rabbi Yudah said that it's invalid shchita. Azal Rabbi Abba amar akramed Rabbi Lazar. Azal Rabbi Lazar amar akramed Rabbi Yochanan. Amar lei, ma ishna? Amar lei, shachat bimkom nekev, nasa kami ששחט עובד כוכבים וגמר ישראל. It's like if he cut through the hole, it's the same as you have idolater who cut halfway through the windpipe and then a fellow Jew finish the cut, in which the shechita is valid. Shachat upaga bo negev na'asa kemi sheshachat Yisrael v'gamar oved kochavim. So that's make the shechita not possible because the oved kochavim is the one who motzi nefesh. The moment is motzi nefesh, the Mefarshim said that that's make it invalid. You see more in Tosfot, the Bo'a Metchil Shachat, the Marsha, Maharam, and more. Anyway, Karele, Oved Kochavim, Oved Kochavim. We call it idolater, idolater. Omar Rav HaShapir, Karele, Oved Kochavim, Oved Kochavim. Bish, Lama Atam, Edavel, Israel, Mishchat Ruba, Velo Shachat, Ki Nafka Chayuta Biyadea, De Oved Kochavim, Ka Nafka. Ela Acha, Migdeish, Mishchat Shachit, Mali Mimkom Nekev, Mali Pagabo Nekev. What's the difference, the whether they slaughter a cut through the hole or he reached a hole? So Rashi said here, Michdei mishchat shachit, kol hanimtza ba, v'trefot b'chatzi kane lohave, v'avi letchila kikane shlema, v'arei shachut lefaneh l'ulma b'mkom nekev v'chulei. So from here you derive that if you have kane, you have a windpipe, Chetzi chatuch me'atzmo, there's half a cut by itself, it's not considering a trefa. So he basically, you have to slaughter only the chetzi ha'shalem, and if you do that, then the shechita is befitting. But as we said, we have much more to discuss in this matter. You see a lot in the halachot when it's come to this, and obviously we just here to le'orer. And those who wants to go more with this is obviously is the Rambam Hilchot Shechita and Tur Shulchan Aruch Yoredei Hilchot Shechita and Nosei HaKelim.